All right, guys, we are looking at trans artists today. I know it's taken me a minute to get this up, but I have a lot of images and it took a little while. But we're going to start out with talking about Zachary Drucker, probably one of my favorite trans artists. Zachary Drucker has been sort of a cultural producer and independent artist working typically in photography as well as video and text. And a lot of these artists you'll see are trying to break down the way we think about gender, sexuality, and scene. She has been working on a couple of different series like This Is Me and Transparent, and sort of infusing different elements of photography, video, and text and performance into her work. She states, "With self-awareness and agency, my work reinvents and redistributes relationships of spectacle, spectator, domesticated, exoticized, dominator, and subjugated." And talking also about drag performance as well as representation of queer people. The first series I wanted to talk about, kind of relating back to our conversations about drag, is the series of photographs that Zachary Drucker took of Mother Flawless Sabrina. And if you remember this film from one of the readings, I want to say it was from the Club Kids reading. Mother Flawless Sabrina is actually the narrator of this film, as well as featured on the cover here, putting on her drag makeup for the film in 1968. So Zachary meets her in New York City and very much develops this kind of very personal relationship with her. And she's this very famous sort of drag queen, and is this massive queer icon during the time, and really becomes sort of an important figure to a lot of different people, including Drucker as well. I'll show you some images of her in her youth. And here's her with Drucker. So she was working, Drucker was very much working to create a collection or archive of images of Mother Flawless Sabrina, as well as sort of taking pictures of her home. She was aging, and she ended up passing in the November of 2017. And so she really wanted to kind of make this collective group of images of her to sort of memorialize her, as well as to sort of protect this history of her life and her images and her work. So you can see some of the photographs that she took with Zachary Drucker as well. So these are some of those famous photographs from this series that she took very kind of late, later in Mother Flawless Sabrina's life. It's kind of beautiful to see these little personal images. I really like the way that Drucker kind of not only is photographing sort of the room and portraits, but also sort of these very kind of intimate images as well of Mother Flawless Sabrina. And like I stated, that Drucker and Mother Flawless Sabrina meet when Drucker sort of first moved to New York in 2001. And you have that Drucker decides to sort of photograph the people in New York City, specifically sort of the drag culture and the queer culture, because she feels an attachment to them. And she says, "I stood outside the gates to photograph performers and festival goers as they left, which felt as awkward as it sounds, until I laid eyes on Mother Flawless Sabrina. She happily consented to being photographed, pointed her finger directly in my lens, and said, 'You're on the wrong side of the camera, kid.' And Drucker says, "I was home." And so here is that image that she took in 2001 of her at Wigstock. And Drucker also wrote this obituary about Mother Flawless Sabrina as well, which is quite sort of sad and beautiful. And I have some sort of clips from it here. I liked this line as well that she stated, "I should mention that Flawless had no preference for pronouns or names, and even I have called her different things at different points in my life. Grandma, Flawless, Sabrina, Jack, he, she, they, it was all okay, at your pleasure." And so Jack is her male persona name. And her sort of motto or catchphrase. "Normal is a setting on the dryer. Wherever you are is the center of the universe. Reality is a mass hunch. You are the person you've been waiting for. If it doesn't make you nervous, it isn't worth doing. Everything you do is perfect. You're the boss, applesauce. It's your movie. Own it." It's also really interesting that Mother Flawless Sabrina also sort of called herself a gender clown. She is very much kind of part of the older club kids. And so these performance spaces were very sort of different for her, in that she wasn't necessarily in sort of the high fashion version of that, but more sort of the glam version of sort of early drag queens. And she talks about how she's a master survivor or a veteran of loss because she had lost so many friends who had died of HIV or AIDS. And she states that she moved through friends like Sylvia Rivera, Crystal LaBeija, Dorian Gray, Dorian Corey, International Crisis. And yet she still continued to stay sort of so positive as well. Another icon that Drucker photographed is Rosalind for Aperture magazine. And I realize that I spelled Aperture wrong. But another sort of very infamous icon in the club scene, in the ball scene, with Rosalind and sort of photographing her for this famous series at the time. And here's some images of her from the 70s and 80s. She states, "My transition from young white boy with a false sense of privilege in the 1970s to a young tranny girl with little or no privilege was a real smack in the face," Rosalind Blumenstein wrote in her 2003 autobiography, Branded Tea. "My spirit and soul seemed to be uplifted and smashed on a daily basis." And so again, Drucker is contemplating and photographing these sort of older queens, icons, to catalog their sort of history, their lives, and try to embrace some of that history and information. Zachary's also worked with Amos Mack, and we'll talk about Amos Mack shortly here after we talk about Drucker. But this series by Mack and Drucker is super important and interesting and valuable. And again, one of the series that I really like, which is called Distance is Where the Heart Is, Home is Where You Hang Your Heart, from 2011. Which was basically these two photographers coming together and went to Drucker's old sort of childhood home. And it had snowed in sort of this weekend in Syracuse, New York. And so they ended up taking these photographs about Drucker's personal history there, And to kind of intervene in this space and to rethink sort of how Drucker felt as a child there, experience in cross identity representation, and a dialogue between Mac, a trans man, and Drucker, a trans woman. And so you have Drucker kind of going into this space and playing with some of these objects and images from her childhood and in these spaces, and some of them are sort of awkward and others are sort of beautiful. According to, I believe, her artist website, keeping normative culture on the periphery, distances where the heart is, explores the relationship between spectacle and voyeur as uniquely removed from the trappings of representational asymmetry, veering between classically sikh fashion editorials to sexed up fetishism, site-specific bodyworks and body as target performances. The photo essay imagines a stratagem where difference is graded into a fine dust settling over the ruins of normality, devoid of traditional male-female power dynamics. Mac and Drucker's mutual bond and kinship as trans people results in the visual free-for-all that plays with sexuality, female subjugation, power, wealth, vulnerability, victimization, family comfort, safety, and secrets. So Drucker kind of going in, wearing some of the clothes that she used to wear, investigating some of the space that she used to spend time in, and really thinking about those things, and sort of what, how that kind of plays in on her life as a whole. Drucker and Mac also go out into like the cold, and take these pictures, which are kind of gorgeous, of her at sort of her old school, I think like in the football field. There's Drucker's mother, as well, who also participates in her work. So you can see sort of the images here of her in that like big fur coat in the middle of the snow. Which is the cover of the Trans Lady fanzine that I have, that I was showing you guys the other day. Drucker has also worked with Rise Ernst in producing this really interesting introspective look at a couple as they sort of transition together in this photographic series and book called Relationship. It was the six-year romance, which ended with the release of the photographs in 2014 at the Whitney, which is kind of sad. And I haven't seen a whole lot of information about why they broke up or sort of what the situation may be. But they have worked on the show Transparent together. And then through their lives together, they have made this sort of private visual diary of their transition together. So Drucker going from male to female, and then Ernst going from female to male. So they produced this entire series, which they consider sort of an autoethnography, which Drucker defines as the practice of creating self-reflexive work or work that reflected my community, was the guiding impulse for the photographs in Relationship. So here's the very first photograph that they took in 2008 with, yes, a digital camera. Oh, so beautiful. And a lot of this series had to do with demystifying the trans existence. That's why people have so many burning questions about it all, kind of trying to be sort of an open book. That's something that's not seen, necessarily, and trying to be very open about that experience personally, as well as sort of their relationship together. This is a very early one as well. Also, when they were installing the work, people would ask them who the photographer was, stating that they assumed that we were just the subjects, which of course the history of this kind of work, but this is what I hope changes going forward. It's the work we're doing in television, it's the work we're doing in filmmaking, making trans people the author rather than just the subject. They're obviously being very open with their lives and sort of the physical changes in their bodies, which makes this photographic series, I think, so incredibly sort of special and personal as well. Oh, here's an image of them today. And this is a big, quite large bulk of text, but it's interesting because Ernst is talking about this concept of sort of passing, right? Which is that people started to think about them as a heterosexual couple and what that sort of meant for them, and what happens to assimilate, where you pass and it's really not even an issue anymore? Do you walk away from that life and don't look back? It's a conundrum of the trans community in that it is an evaporating community in a way. It's like a group of people that are able to assimilate into a binary world and have no acknowledgement of their transgender history, and that happens a lot more than anyone thinks it does because people are able to assimilate really effectively. What it merely means to me is gender freedom for everybody. A lot of transgender people can look at how transgender people can live their lives and be themselves and find the middle space or whatever that is, and it's emancipating for everybody who lives in a binary box. And here's some more images of them as they've worked on Transparent together as well. The last series that I kind of threw in here last minute about or by Drucker, I'm sorry, is this Southern for Pussy, a little kind of like goofy video, in which I don't know, it's kind of like this punny video, but at the same time it's about proposing an advanced world where transness is incidental and so embedded in everyday life that it's not even mentioned by name. And so it's a this very like kind of interesting and beautiful recording of their relationship together, and sort of these conversations surrounding trans lives as well. I like this quote by Drucker. I just threw it in here, as well as some images of Transparent and this series, and some quotes about it as well. Which you can read if you like.